Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. Have you ever taken a family picture at a holiday or gathering and had problems getting everyone, especially small children, to smile for the picture? You may end up retaking a lot of pictures, but there always seems to be one person or more that is not smiling. I recently was asked to fix a family picture in Photoshop. When I was done, I was jokingly told, "That's great, but it would be nice if some people were smiling." I was aware of the facial adjustment features in Photoshop CC Liquid Filter, so I decided to add a smile to those in the pictures that needed it. I was surprised at how easy it was to get them to smile. No artistic ability, but only a basic knowledge of Photoshop is required to do it. It's really simple. I got to thinking of all the photos of families, babies, children, holiday gatherings, weddings, graduations, etc., where one or more people were not smiling. These people could easily be smile enhanced to improve the photo. So I tested it out in this video tutorial. If you have at least version 2015.5 Photoshop Creative Cloud, you can easily enhance the smiles of people in your photographs. If you are a photographer and you have Photoshop Lightroom Creative Cloud, you are currently eligible for free Photoshop CC. If you have a friend who has Photoshop, ask them to help you. If they are not familiar with the face-aware features of the Liquify Filter, show them this video. Next, I will show you some examples of how to enhance smiles in Photoshop. We'll begin with a single baby picture. Pictures of babies make some of the most precious photographs. However, sometimes babies just don't feel like smiling for us. Start by opening Photoshop. Choose File, Open, and browse to where you placed a copy of your digital photo on your computer. If you are a more experienced Photoshop user, you may have already used Photoshop, Camera Raw, or Lightroom to adjust the image for color, brightness, contrast, luminance, etc. Select the image, then press Open to place it in Photoshop. Your image opens in Photoshop. Now choose File, Save As. Change the Save As type to Photoshop PSD. Click the Save button. Now we are working with a copy of your image in Photoshop PSD file format. A layer is created in the Layers panel named Background. It's always a good idea to make a duplicate of your original image. Right-click on the background layer and choose Duplicate Layer. A dialog box will appear. Change the layer name to Work and click OK to accept. This is the layer we will be working with. If you think you may print this photo at a later time, you should change the image resolution to at least 300 pixels per inch. For example, for this image, to check the image, choose Image, Image Size from the menu. First, change the measurement method to inches or centimeters, depending on what measurement method you are most comfortable with. I used inches. The width is 26.6 inches and the height is 17.7 inches. And the resolution is 72 pixels per inch. You probably don't want to print that size for this picture. If you did, it wouldn't look good at 72 pixels per inch. So approximate what standard width might be appropriate. I'm guessing this might be close to a 6 by 4 inch print. So change your width to a little more than 6 inches, say 6.5. The height automatically should adjust to 4.3 inches to keep the image in the same aspect ratio. Leave resample checked. Choose a Preserve Details method and change the resolution to 300 pixels per inch. Then click OK. The image resamples at 6.5 width and 4.3 height, but at a 300 pixel per inch resolution. Now I will show you how to improve the baby's smile. First, you should make the work layer a smart object. This will give you the ability to go back into your smile settings and readjust them, even after saving the picture. Right-click on the work layer and choose Convert to Smart Object. Now from the menu, choose Filter Liquify. The Liquify screen appears. On the left are all the Liquify tools. You will only be using the Face tool in this tutorial. If the Face tool is not already active, select it. In the Properties panel, you will see a section named Face Aware Liquify. Below it will be the properties for eyes, nose, mouth, and face shape. Click the Mouth drop-down to expand the mouth options. In this video, we are only dealing with the smile setting. If you hover your mouse over the baby's face, you will see white guidelines to show you the areas you can modify. When you hover over the baby's mouth, you should also see white guidelines around the mouth. Hold down your left mouse key and drag up to increase the smile as demonstrated. Release the mouse. Notice the smile slider has a value of 58. Where 100 would represent the maximum smile available. You can now adjust this slider to further adjust the smile. Try to be subtle here. On some people, 100 is too much. On this picture, I decided to use a value of 68. But since this adjustment is a smart object, I can always go back and readjust the smile settings. You can also preview the before and after by turning on and off the preview checkbox on the bottom of the Properties panel. Press OK to accept the modifications. Here is another example with two girls inside the Liquify tool. The Face tool can recognize multiple faces in an image. So it's just a matter of following the guidelines around the mouth of each girl and adjusting a bit. Face Aware Liquify numbers each face from left to right. So now that I've made initial adjustments with the mouse, I can go into the sliders of each face and adjust more if needed. You can also change the smile of a person standing sideways. This concludes the tutorial. Have fun bringing smiles out.